गुड आफ्टरनून वन एंड ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 11, 12 एंड 13. सी द फर्स्ट दैट इज एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 11. इन दैट द एम इज सेम टू आइडेंटिफाई द गिवन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड D8 बाय सिस्टमैटिक क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस. यू नो द स्टेप्स इन्वॉल्व इन क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस. यू स्टडीड फर्दर दैट इज प्रिलिमिनरी एनालिसिस, फिजिकल कॉन्स्टेंट, एलिमेंटल एनालिसिस, ग्रुप एनालिसिस, रिजल्ट विद रेफरेंस टू लिटरेचर, देन कन्फर्मेटिव टेस्ट, आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ ड्रग. सो दिस D8 कंपाउंड, सी द कंपाउंड. सी दिस इज अवर D8 कंपाउंड. इट इज अ कलरलेस इन नेचर. इट इज सॉलिड इन स्टेट, कलरलेस, एंड इट हैव एन प्लीजेंट ओडर. सो द इन्फरेंस इज दैट कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, फिनॉल, एरोमेटिक एसिड्स मे बी प्रेजेंट. Then next steps in preliminary analysis is their solubility. This compound is soluble in water and it turns blue litmus to red. That means it is acidic in nature. Then it is soluble in two normal NaOH solution and also it is insoluble in dilute HCl. Then next step, that is action of concentrated H2SO4. With H2SO4 it gives blackening of our compound. Then next step, that is action of Na2CO3 solution. So it gives the effervescence of CO2, that means acid is present. Then the next step in preliminary analysis, that is the action of KMnO4 solution. So there is a in observation decolorization observed, that means unsaturated compound, this D8 is unsaturated compound. And action of bromine water, again it shows decolorization. That is, again it is unsaturated compound. Then action of FeCl3 solution, it gives violet color with FeCl3 solution. That means our compound, in our D8 compound, phenol is present. Then it also gives sooty flame when hitting on the wire gauze or spatula. That means it is an aromatic compound. So in preliminary analysis we conclude that it is an aromatic compound. Then it is unsaturated compound and it is acidic in nature. Then next step is their physical constant. In that determination of physical constant, this D8 compound, it melts at 158 degrees Celsius. That means its melting point is 158 degrees Celsius. Then in elemental analysis, we go for sodium fusion test. In sodium fusion test, when we perform the sodium fusion test for D8 compound, in that we observed that nitrogen is absent, sulfur is absent and halogens are also absent. Then in group analysis, the test for acid is positive. That is carboxylic acid, there may be carboxylic acid. Then in elemental in group analysis again, the test for phenols are also positive. That means when we go for group analysis, our compound contains carbon, hydrogen and oxygen and it is acidic in nature. That's why we go for that different test for group analysis. In that we observe that the test for acid is positive and test for phenols are positive. So this compound D8 gives near about the same test, near about same result for the test as same as that of benzoic acid. So in group analysis we get the result that it is acid, carboxylic acid and phenol, these two functional groups are present. Then after referring to the literature, we observe that we go for the confirmative test. In that the confirmative test for, we perform the confirmative test for different acid, we observe that test for salicylic acid is positive. So this D8 compound, it is salicylic acid. It is a keratolytic. It uses keratolytic, and so this D8 compound, it is a compound having 158 degrees Celsius melting point. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, these elements are present. It consists of carboxylic acid and phenol as a functional group, and therefore with reference to the literature, the compound may be salicylic acid. Then see the next experiment, that is experiment number 12. Same aim, to identify the given organic compound. It is D9 compound by systematic qualitative analysis. Here see our compound, that is D9. See, this is our D9 compound, which is colorless, having pleasant odor, and see, it is soluble in water. It does not turn blue litmus red. That means, and also does not turn red litmus blue. That means it is neutral in nature. It is soluble in two normal NaOH solution. Then action of Na2CO3 solution. It does not show effervescence of CO2. That means acid is absent. Then next step in preliminary analysis, that is action of KMnO4 solution. So this D9 compound with KMnO4 solution, it does not shows decolorization of KMnO4. That means it is a saturated compound. Then with action of bromine water, it also does not shows decolorization. That means it is again saturated compound. Then action of FeCl3 solution, that is when our substance liquid plus a drop of FeCl3 solution, no violet color is produced. That means phenol is absent. Then heating with on the copper gauze or on spatula, it is, does not show sooty flame. It get evaporated fast. That means it is, this compound is not aromatic. It is aliphatic in nature. So this D9 compound, it is a saturated compound, it is aliphatic in nature, and it is neutral in nature. Then we shifted to next test, that is a physical constant determination. As it is liquid, its boiling point is 56 degrees Celsius. We observed the boiling point, it is 56 degrees Celsius. Then in elemental analysis, when we go for the elemental analysis, in that we perform the sodium fusion test and also test for nitrogen, sulfur and halogens. Three tests are absent in elemental analysis, that is nitrogen absent, sulfur absent and halogens are also absent for this compound D9. So with reference to literature, when we observed carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, these three elements are present. Then we shifted to the group analysis, that is functional group determination, and it is a neutral in nature. So we performed the next test with the help of literature, that we observed that we performed the test for aldehyde and ketone. In that, aldehyde tests are positive. That is our compound plus 5 ml of Schiff's reagent, a small quantity of substance, we observe that purple color we get. That is aldehyde is confirmed or aldehyde functional group is present. Then we go for ketone test. In that, few drop of sodium nitroprusside and few drop of NaOH solution we added in our compound, we give the red color in the test tube. That means ketones is functional group is also present. That means our D9 compound, it consists of ketone functional group and also acetone functional group. Then we go for the confirmatory test. In that, we perform the confirmatory test. In that, 1 ml of sample, 0.1 ml of meta dinitrobenzene plus excess of NaOH solution, we give violet color. Violet color is observed. That means our compound is ketone, or ketone get confirmed. In that our compound is acetone. Test for acetone get positive. That means our compound is acetone. See, the structure of acetone is given here. It is used as an organic solvent. Then the next experiment, that is experiment number 13, the same aim to identify the given organic compound. Here D9 compound is there. To identify the given organic compound D9 by systematic qualitative analysis. Sorry, it is D10 compound. You studied D9 for experiment number 12. It is D10 compound. In that, see, we have to perform preliminary analysis, physical constant, elemental analysis, group analysis, result with reference to literature, confirmative test and identification of drug. Here, see, then compound D10. See, it is having brown, dark brown color, and again it have a pleasant odor. Then when we performed the next test, that is solubility, it is insoluble in water, and then it turns red litmus to blue. That means it is basic in nature. And it does not show effervescence with Na2CO3 solution. That means it is a not acidic in nature. Then the test, like with H2SO4, it is insoluble in H2SO4, also insoluble in NaOH solution and HCl. Then next steps, that is action of KMnO4 solution, it gives decolorization of KMnO4. That means it is an unsaturated compound. Also, it causes recolorization of with bromine water. That is, again, it is unsaturated compound. Then it gives sooty flame when heating on the spatula. That means it is aromatic in nature. So D10 compound, it is aromatic in nature. Then it is unsaturated compound and it is a basic in nature. So we perform the next step, that is elemental analysis. In elemental analysis, we observe that is in sodium fusion test, when we perform the different tests like test for nitrogen, it is a positive test which gives blue-green color in the test of nitrogen, so nitrogen is present. Then test for sulfur and halogens are absent, that is sulfur absent, halogens absent. So our compound D10, it contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen, these elements. Then we shifted to next test, that is determination of functional group. In functional group determination, we observed that the test for aliphatic nitro compound is negative, that it does not give yellowish solution or precipitate, in that aliphatic nitrogen is absent. But the next test, that is test for aromatic nitrogen compound, nitro compound, it gives red wine color it produces, so that our compound is, or our D10, this compound contain aromatic nitro compound as a functional group. So our D10 compound, it consists of amine functional group. It have melt boiling point 184 degree Celsius. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen elements are present and amine functional group is present. So we shifted to next test, that is the confirmative test. Here we perform diazotization test. In that substance plus HCl, then we have to cool it. Then we have to add few drop of NaNO2 solution, and we also add ice cold solution of beta naphthol. In this test in NaOH, we observe that orange dye get produced. That means here the aniline is confirmed. So our D10 compound is aniline. See the structure of aniline here, and it is an pharmaceutical aid. It is also used as an pesticide antioxidant. So our D10 compound is aniline.